two boys. Vicente is already 11 years old. I'm still in denial. And then the youngest is Paul, who also just turned 9. My two boys are absolutely competitive, just like their dad, and maybe a little bit of me as well. Vicente is a scientist. He really wants to grow up to be a scientist, to be an astronomer, to be an astronaut, and he's well into the sciences, not so much into sports. The other one is into sports, music, arts. So they're quite different, but I'm glad that they truly get along, especially for us. When they see and they notice that we get uncomfortable because they're not getting along, they adjust. And so they're very sensitive to how we feel about them and about how they're dealing with each other. They're very good with other kids, although there are moments when they struggle to also get along with each other, and they would have their own factions. But at the end of the day, they love each other. We ask them if they want to have separate rooms, but at the end of it, they just want to be together. And we love that. I'm absolutely proud of those two. When they asked me what was one of the best things, or what is the best things of motherhood, I would always go back to when I was still nursing my children, when they were absolutely dependent on me and Vince to protect them, to care for them, and to nurture them. And they really just needed us every step of the way. Well, one of my greatest worries has always been not being able to measure up to the type of mother that I should be, the mother that God had wanted me to be. And it's really a lot of factors that go into it. I chose a path where I'm a career woman. I have been doing corporate work for some years now, and that's a path that I chose 5.5 years ago. And it has taken away some time, or it has pushed me to have a different approach when it comes to motherhood. Sure, I still consider myself as a hands-on mom, and being a hands-on mom doesn't mean that you're lording over your kids 24/7 and that you're there and that you're homeschooling, although that's my dream, and to do all these things. I'm still a hands-on mom because I'm still that one, the mother that they depend on. I'm still the go-to person whenever they have problems, concerns, issues, or wants and needs. So my greatest fear is not being able to balance that. And it's a struggle. It's an everyday struggle. So I salute all of those who are great mothers who also get a balance in life and be able to achieve all of their lifelong dreams as individuals as well, not just as mothers, but as career women, business women, or women who are just doing a lot of things for others apart from their family. Another thing that makes me happy about my children is when I see them with their dad. It's different. Having these two boys and just the way they are with Vince, or maybe it's the way Vince is with them. It's just a thrill to watch the three of them wrestle, run after each other, or sit there and read, talk, discuss about being a gentleman, about being a good boy. When Vince emphasizes on opening the door for mom, or making sure that they, don't play too rough with mom, but that's okay with me. Because I'm a lady, we don't treat ladies like that. You know, every now and then these boys have burping contests, and I can't help it. Not that I join, but Vince would always tell them, not when the ladies are around. I'm absolutely grateful to have a great husband who's been so supportive, who's been allowing me to pursue my career and support me, because motherhood would be a lot more stressful if I knew that my kids' needs weren't met because I don't have enough hours in the day, or I don't have enough energy. So obviously a part of motherhood is Vince's role as a father also fulfilling and helping me become the mother that I can be, the mother that I ought to be. So that's one great part of motherhood, is that I have a great husband to work with me on that and to make me a better mom. And also, the best part about motherhood is that I have two kids who really teach me a lot. Seeing life through their eyes, seeing how the world is through their eyes, it's really special. It's different. I've always I've always put a lot of pressure on myself with a lot of things, but that's just the way I am. Maybe it's because of my competitive spirit, or maybe it's just because I usually, and it's a character flaw, aim to please. and there's a lot of things that you know, I tell myself that I need to do, but at the end of it, my kids would say, it's not important, Mom. Or they would say, no, well, let's just eat in front of the TV, or okay, let's just do this, or let's just go walk around. They actually simplify things, and I think parents sometimes miss that. Parents might forget to see things in the eyes of their children because we think what's important to them is something that we already know. We fail to acknowledge, and sometimes maybe realize that what our children truly need is exactly what they're seeing. You know, Mommy Mundo has really been a part of my motherhood journey from the beginning, when I was a clueless mom, didn't know what to do. And even with my second child, motherhood and the way motherhood has been, with the tools, the clothes, the even the groups that are available, the support groups, the talks and all of them, they have always helped me with my approach, not just from the nursing stage though. Someone who really had no clue, because my mother-in-law was in the U.S. and my own mom was also in Canada all throughout, so I had to figure things out a lot on my own, through friends and some relatives and Mommy Mundo and other people that are in that community. But all throughout, even as my kids were growing up, there were a lot of things that I learned, from being able to not just teach values to your kids, but being able to enjoy a fun afternoon with kids, what to prepare for your kids, and all these things that make it easier to be a mom, you know, to exude, whether it's the big important things like choosing what school, what kind of education, and what are the things that are out there that we should consider, or little things like how to make baller. You know, those are important things, and I just wish that more moms would also have access, and I'm sure that Mommy Mundo will continue to strive to provide this access to other moms. Motherhood doesn't need to be difficult, and you need not feel alone. Even if you have your family surrounding you, supporting you, there's a big community out there of moms who are just willing to share. Not just their expertise, but share the joys of motherhood, so you can also elevate your knowledge of being a mom. And there's just a lot of products out there that Mommy Mundo has helped, that whether they were products of moms also that are going into business or other types of companies, but these products have made it even more enjoyable and easier for all of us moms, because we have choices. So what I truly love about Mommy Mundo is just making us moms feel that there's always another mother out there that's going through exactly what you're going through, but at the same time, we'll also have a group, we'll also have a community, we'll also have other mothers out there who are willing to help you out.